I've loved, I've laughed, and I've cried. I've had my fill, my share of losing. And now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing. I live a life that's full. I've traveled each and every byway. There's more, much more than this. I did it all.
Let us all stand. Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the earth or the mountain were brought forth, thou art God. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide in the shadow of the Almighty. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When my enemies and my foes came to eat of my flesh, they stumble and they fail. Though a host should encamp about me, I shall not be moved. Lord, you have been our dwelling place throughout all generations. Before the mountains were born, or you brought forth the whole world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. You turn people back to the dust, saying, return to dust, O you mortals, for 1,000 years in your sight, or like a day that has just gone by, or like a watch in the night. You sweep people away in the sleep of death. They are like the new grass in the morning. In the morning, it springs up new, but by evening, it is dry and withers away. We are consumed by your anger and terrified by your indignation. You have set our iniquities before you, our secret sins in the light of your presence. All of our days pass away under your wrath. We finish our years with a moan. Our days may come to be 70 years or 80. If our strength endures, yet the best of them be but of trouble and sorrow, for they quickly pass, and we all fly away. If only we knew the power of your anger. Your wrath is as great as the fear that is due. Lord, teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart for wisdom. Relent, O Lord, how long will it be? Have compassion on your servants. Satisfy us in the morning with your unfailing love, that we may sing for joy and be glad all our days. Make us glad for as many days as you have afflicted us, for as many years as we have seen trouble. May our deeds be shown to your servants and the splendor to their children. May the favor of the Lord our God rest upon us. Establish the work of our hands for us. Yes, establish the work of our hands. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. Leads me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. Lead me the path of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with feathers, and under his wings shall I trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. You may be seated. Let church say amen. We are here this morning for the homegoing of our beloved brother, our esteemed, distinguished brother, Brother George Kelly. Can we just give the Lord a hand clap and give him some praise for the life of Brother Kelly? Amen. We will now have the scripture. First, we will hear from Brother Martin McElrath as he delivers the Old Testament, and then from Mrs. Yvette White as she renders the New Testament, followed by Brother Martin Brown as he will offer the prayer of comfort.
Good morning, family. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. There where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Ye have known me, ye should have known my Father also. From henceforth ye know him, and I have seen him. John 14, first to the seventh verse. God have a blessed reading of the word.
Good morning, family. Reading from Psalm 118, verses 1 to 2 and 9 to 29. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let Israel say, his love endures forever. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes. All the nations surround me, but in the name of the Lord, I cut them down. They surround me on every side, but in the name of the Lord, I cut them down. They swarm around me like bees, but they were consumed as quickly as burning thorns. In the name of the Lord, I cut them down. I was pushed back and about to fall, but the Lord helped me. The Lord is my strength and my defense. He has become my salvation. Shouts of joy and victory resound in the tents of the righteousness. The Lord's right hand has done mighty things. The Lord's right hand is lifted high. The Lord's right hand has done mighty things. I will not die, but live, and will proclaim what the Lord has done. The Lord has chastened me severely, but he has not given me over to death. Open for me the gates of the righteous. I will enter and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord, through which the righteousness may enter. I will give you thanks, for you answer me. You have become my salvation. The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The Lord has done this, and it is marvelous. Marvelous in our eyes. The Lord has done this. It is the very day. Let us rejoice today and be glad. Lord, save us. Lord, grant us success. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. For the house of the Lord, we bless you. From the house of the Lord, we bless you. The Lord is God, and he has made his light shine on us, which bow in hand, join in the festival procession up to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, and I will exalt you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Amen.
Good morning. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles so that we can comfort those in trouble with the comfort that we receive from him. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we just come to you today to honor a man, a dear friend, a father, a brother, grandfather, uncle, cousin. Lord, we thank you for George Kelly. We thank you for the man that he was. We thank you, Lord, for his integrity, his strength, his cool. Lord, we thank you for George. We thank you for him being a man of his word, man of strength. Lord, I thank you for him being the kind of man that I could trust with the keys to my house and the safety of my children and my wife. He was a good man, Lord. We thank you for him. Lord, we pray for the comfort now of his friends, his family, his relatives. Lord, you say that you will heal the brokenhearted, that you will bind up their wounds, and we ask you to do that now. Lord, we pray for peace, a peace that will surpass even our own understanding. We pray for hope, Lord, hope in an eternal salvation. Lord, we pray for grace, grace to walk another day. We pray for hope, Lord, and love. Lord, it is our prayer that you would bless us as we move forward. And it is my prayer, Lord Jesus, for all of us, that you would bless us and keep us. That you would shine your face upon us and be gracious to us. That your very countenance would be upon us and grant us peace. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Brother McElrath, Ms. White, and Brother Brown. We will now have a musical selection by Minister Sean Stovall.
Faced the final curtain, my friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I've traveled each day, every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my regrets. I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there's no doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all, and I stood tall. I did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried. I had my fear, my share of losing. And now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all of that. And may I say, not in a shy way, oh no, no, not me, I did it my way. Oh, for what is a man what he's got? I'm not himself, then he was not. To say the things he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows, I did it my way. For what is a man, what has he got, if not himself, then he has not. To say the things that he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows, I did it my way.
greet you today in the only name that matters, and that is the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the one who greets us, orders our steps, and meets us with mercy. To the Spirit of the Lord that is certainly in this place, just give God some praise for the life of Brother George Kelly. And we thank God for his life. To our officiating minister on today, Pastor Pearson, all clergy assembled, to our musician, and to this most precious family, this wife and these sons, we want you to know that we're praying for you, and we thank God that he's still able to keep you in the midst of an unkeepable situation. The family would have me to thank each and every one of you for your presence here today, all many acts of kindness shown to them in the passing of their loved one. And family, we want to let you know that on behalf of the entire staff of J.M. Wilkerson Funeral Establishment, we're praying for you. We here at Wilkerson believe in prayer and the power of prayer. We know that prayer can and will change things. So, Sister Wanda, to these sons, we want you to know that we're saying this little prayer for you, and it simply goes as thus, that God would grant you the serenity to accept the things in which you cannot change, courage to change the things that you can, but most of all, wisdom to know the difference. We invoke the companionship of the Holy Spirit to wrap his loving arms protection around you and to be with you even in the midnight hour. So family, do this for us. Look to the hills from which cometh all of your help, and realize that all of your help come from the Lord. May God bless you, and may heaven smile upon each and every one of you. God bless you.
Thank you, sir. We'll now have reflections coming from Brother George McCray, as well as Brother Eric McCray.
To our family, the loved ones and friends. Lord, forgive us of our sins and our conscious and unconscious mind. Purge us with hyssop. Clean us, wash us as white as snow in the blood of Jesus Christ. Dad, he was meticulous. He was kind, he was humorous, he filled all of our hearts with joy, with compassion. He assured us of hope, he assured us of laughter. He encouraged each and every one of us to do better in everything that we did and what we will do. He never complained. He was honest. He was bold. If you said something to him, he was going to give it to you like it is. He didn't hold anything back. You can always go to George Kelly and tell him how you felt, and he will tell you how he felt and what you should have done with regard to what the situation was. I remember when I first came to the house, and I was scared. This was the first time I came to the house, and Wanda hadn't gotten home from work yet. She would get home about 7. Mine would get home about 7. I'd probably been there about 4, and we sitting in the living room, and we are waiting. We would talk, and that time that I spent initially with him, He said, "Are you okay?" I said, "Yes, I'm okay." He made sure that I was comfortable. He didn't initiate any conversation initially. He just wanted to make sure that I was comfortable being around him. So with that being said, our relationship grew to the best relationship that I could have ever had from my dad. He always would tell me to pursue my dreams. He always would say, do what your heart tells you to do. He encouraged all of us to do the same. He was always there. And the one thing that we had in common, he loved to dance. I mean, he would love to dance. And there wasn't a song that he didn't know that he couldn't dance to. And if you wanted to know how to dance, you're going to go to George Kelly and he's going to show you how to dance. He's going to show you some steps. He's going to show you some finger moves. You want to be a Temptation, he's going to show you how to spin. And Ma, she was right there. She was right there with him. He traveled. They traveled. It wasn't nowhere that they didn't go together. He was with Ma. They was together. They held each other up. They loved each other. It wasn't nothing that he would not have done for each and every one of us that is sitting here today. He filled our hearts with joy and laughter. Dad, you're going to be missed. You are missed. But we know that you are in a heavenly place and that God has you. The Holy Spirit, the Trinity has you. And as you look down upon all of us, just know that each and every one of us love you and care. And without further ado, I just want to thank each and every one of you for being here. Family, cousins, nephews, everyone. But I want to do a little dance that he did.
First, I want to give thanks to the Most High for this opportunity to share in my dad's life, his family, which now becomes my family. When he always spoke, he never spoke in a sort of past tense, so I'm not going to do that now. What we know is that he's not physically here, but he's spiritually here. God makes all things, right? Seen and unseen. I've only known my father for a short period of time, too short. And this week has been a week, and is a week of celebration. I want to give thanks to everyone who I've spent time with and who were able to share stories with me about my dad's life, particularly Tyron, Isaiah, Stephen, who spent a lot of time with him, and definitely my Wanda. So here we are celebrating his welcoming nature. When I found my dad, I gave him a hard time. It wasn't easy for me. He kept at it. He even, for those I've shared this, what he even called and said, you got a problem with me? You know, I said, yeah. We hashed it out again. He kept coming. So I want to celebrate his acceptance of me, of others, his nature, that's who he was. No matter what. We want to celebrate his wisdom, his intelligence, and his knowledge. And as always was, according to my dad, it was always on his personal experiences. It was about him. Wasn't nothing fake or funny about it. He told his truth, no matter what. And we are definitely, as my brother said, celebrating his truth, his honesty. When he spoke, he gave it to you straight. He ain't hold nothing back. And definitely his enjoyment of life, which he displayed through his dance. Through his love of music, his humor. Man, he was funny. His whole style, his dress, his walk. Lastly, you want to celebrate his love for his wife for 47 years. I told my dad, one day he was on the phone, and like I said, he was honest about it. You know, I said, you know, Dad, I love you. You go, yeah, because I was kind of worried about that. He said, I had some concerns for a minute. Right? When I came down one day, he greeted me, hugged me, and kissed me on the cheek. Told me he loved me too. We're celebrating his love for his sons, for his wife, for his friends, family. He wasn't one for goodbyes. Never said goodbye. Is that right? Church say amen. I ain't trying to take your job. I just always wanted to say that. That's a George Kelly humor right there. So Dad would say to me, and I guess he said to others as well, stay nice and kind, child.
Thank you so much to Brother George and Brother Eric McCray. I don't know if you've ever had to in your life make a statement or to express your love or reflections at a homegoing. Have any of you had to do that? Well, if you've ever had to do it, it is one of the most difficult tasks you will ever undertake. So I commend you both for sharing what's real, what's relevant, and what's deep about your father. And it took a lot of courage to do that. It's real difficult. Are y'all with me here? It's real difficult to stand at a time like this and to publicly express your love for someone that you are still grieving and that you recently lost. So that's commendable to do. We're going to move forward now with a musical selection by Brother Tyrod Branch. All right, we're going to do that. Okay, now I had an edition that had Tyrod Branch and then a poetic tribute. That's where that's some they had a write in here. Okay.
Hey y'all. Okay. He sees the tears you cry. He shares your pain inside.
And sometimes you wonder why he allows you to go through what you go through. But just know he has his hands on you. Your days are filled with dark clouds. Even when the sun is out, from the top of your lungs, you shout, will there ever be a change? What will I do? But just know he has his hands on you. He has his hands on you. And he says he'll see you through. When you cry, he's holding you. So just lift your hands up high, for he will provide. So just know he has his hands on you. Sometimes you feel so alone, like a child lost with no home. They keep telling you to be strong, but you say, when will it end? When will I win? Oh, but just know he has his hands on you.
That's it.
Thank you, sir. We'll now have a poetic tribute by Sister Keisha Jackson. Excuse me, a poetic tribute by Sister Keisha Jackson, then followed by a musical selection by Ms. Deneen Powell.
Hello, everyone. I'll be reciting a poem written by Brother Wesley Ingram, known to others as Little Rock. George R. Kelly Jr. In we, you will never die. In we, you will never die. We see you now dancing high, high, high above the sky. In we, you will never die. In we, you will never die. Moving and grooving, creating positive energy, dancing high above the sky. Now you don't have to ask, may I? Because we all know the reason why you chose to fly. In we, you will never die. In we, you will never die. Adios, amigo. Up, up and away. We all will catch up with you in the evening and the morning on a bright and sunny day. In we, you will never die. In we, you will never die. Because now you know the way to fly. Dancing high above the sky, back to the divine source, Christ. In me, you will never die. In me, you will never die. Thank you, George, for standing up and stepping up and walking me down the aisle. Peace to you all.
Now here I go, not part of the program. George R. Kelly, the man, the myth, the legend. Your husband, my uncle, your uncle, your father, your friend, your bro, wasn't interested in fighting, hating, blaming, or being petty with the time he had on this earth. He just wanted to love, be loved, and be at peace. He used to tell me, "You worry too much, Terod. You got the world by the kahunas." I didn't know what he meant, but I think I know now. He was just trying to say I had a good position in life. I had family, I had business. That there was nothing anyone could say bad about my Uncle George. He touched a lot of souls. So, Uncle, you were and will always be an inspiration to myself, the entire family, and anyone you work with. You have left a void in our lives that would never be filled. I will miss you, Uncle George, and I appreciate all the time we spent together. Thank you. Oh, you know what? I'm sorry. You know what? For those of you who knew Uncle George, in his mortal words, adios. You did it your way. Love you all.
Thank you, sir. We'll now hear from Ms. Denine Powell as she renders a musical selection.
Giving all honor to God who has my life, my condolences to the family. I just pray that something that sing that the words of this song brings you some kind of comfort during this time.
Because the Lord is my shepherd, I have everything that I need. He lets me rest in the meadow's grass and leads me beside the quiet streams. He restores my failing health and helps me do what honors him the most. That's why I'm saved. That's why I'm saved. That's why I am saved. I'm saved in his arms. Because the Lord is my shepherd, I have everything that I need. He lets me rest in the meadow's grass, and he leads me beside the quiet streams. He restores my failing health, and he helps me to do what honors him the most. That's why I'm safe, sure not feel safe. That's why I'm safe. I'm safe in his arms. When the storms, when those storms of life and the billows, and the billows roll, I'm so glad he shall hide me. I'm safe in his arms. Now let the Lord in your lonely time be your shepherd. He'll give you everything that you need. He'll let you rest in the meadow grass and lead you beside the quiet streams. He'll restore your failing health, and he'll help you do what honors him the most. That's why I say, I know you say, that's why I say, oh Lord, we're saved in your arms. So when the storms, when those storms called death become your life, hallelujah, and the billows, those billows roll, I'm so glad he shall hide me. I'm so glad he shall hide me. Anybody, are you glad? If you know the Lord, you gotta be glad. Hallelujah. He shall hide me. Hey, I'm so glad. Lord, you got me resting in your arms. Your arms.
Hallelujah. Bless you.
Can we let the church say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let us bow. God, we come in the wonderful, majestic name of Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of our faith, our soon coming King, the one that is, the one that was, and the one that is yet to come. We honor you for your majesty. We praise you for your deity. And we thank you right now for your presence in this place. Oh God, we thank you that your promise is good. You'll never leave us, nor will you forsake us. So we thank you for your presence today. Bless the family, bless Sister Wanda and the sons right now. God, we need you. The whole entire family needs you like never before. Thank you for this life that was given. We know he is safe in your arms. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 This has been a grand celebration, homegoing, very fitting. And I'm going to just take a moment to thank Sister Kelly for trusting me, for asking me to share this moment in time to both sons. Much respect and admiration to you. And I definitely see the reflection and the resemblance in you both. And to all of the other family members that assemble and all friends that have come, may God bless you. For the next few moments, I want to share this word. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, beginning with verse 1. To everything, there is a season. I know you can hear me. And a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal, and a time to break down, and a time to build up. Verse 4, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance. Amen. Let us pray. God, we honor and bless you, that you would bless this word. Prepare those that are listening. Let your word go forth with unction and power. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm going to title this simple message today, He Made the Most of His Time. He made the most of his time. Here in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, the wisest king, Solomon, gives us some life lessons, some heartfelt truths about the brevity, not the longevity, but the brevity of life. I hope you all recognize today that every funeral that we attend is a staunch reminder that we all have but a few days. Solomon, with his great wisdom, tells us that there is a time for everything under the sun. And isn't it quite interesting today that as we reflect on the life of this great man, this giant of a patriarch, this husband of 45 plus years, isn't it amazing for us all to understand that we can learn something from Brother Kelly about time? About time. He made the most of his time. But I wonder, are you going to make the most of yours? There's just a few things I want to point out to you today that we learned from the psalmist. And the first thing he says, or we want to extract here, and that is, there is a time to live. There is a time to live. Now, I know you're trying to be a little silent, give me the silent treatment, but I'm really in your house this morning, because all of us have time to live. And don't waste your time regretting what you should do. Don't waste your time trying to act like you're more spiritual than you really are. Why don't we make the most out of our time? It bothers me when people want to be so spiritual that they are no earthly good. It's concerning to me that some people want to live in a realm which they rarely will be able to achieve. But I just want to make sure that I'm in the right house this morning, because Brother George made the most out of his time. I don't think you're listening this morning. He made the most out of his time because he took his time and did photography. He took photographs. He was handsome, tall, debonair, and distinguished. Yet he was easy on the eye. He was handsome, but he was strong, and he exemplified manhood and masculinity. He made the most out of his time. He worked. He earned a living. He fathered two sons. And don't you know, he made the most out of his time. And don't let it fool you now. He didn't only do it, but he had spare time. He had time after he worked to take photographs, but also he had time to dance. One of his sons hit some of his moves, which I'm not even gonna dare replicate. But it was a time to dance. I know you're looking at me funny, but Christians dance. People in the church dance. Don't act like every dance you've done has always been holy dance and liturgical. You done got down with the get down with some of the best and some of the best clubs around this place. So don't get all cute and quiet on me this morning. I need to make sure that we all understand to make the most out of our time. When you go to a wedding, drop the electric slide. When you go to a party, go on and do the cupid shuffle. When you go somewhere, make sure you make the most out of your time. I'm glad you're now with me. Make the most out of your time. Do not regret your life not doing what you enjoy doing. You can still love God and dance. You can still love God and put on the oldies and the goodies. You can still love God and listen to rap, pop, gospel, or country and give the Lord some praise. But at least make the most out of your time. There you go. He made the most out of his time because he took time to live. But he also made the most out of his time because he took time to love. He loved. I want you to know that every handsome, debonair, dashing man has a soft spot. No matter how much player from the Himalayas, every man has a soft spot. And his soft spot was Sister Wanda. Sometimes, this is what the fellas say, when a fella has a very beautiful woman, the other fellas will observe the brother and the woman, and they'll always say to each other, how did he? Oh, y'all said that too. But we understand he embodied manhood, but his manhood was complemented by this beautiful woman, by this woman that just wasn't a flash in the pan, but she loved him and he loved her for 45 plus years. So what am I saying to you? Don't spend your life lonely by yourself trying to get yours. Make sure that you love somebody along the way. You got to make time to love. Don't work your whole life together just to be lonely with a bunch of degrees on your wall. Make sure you have time to love. He loved his wife. He loved his sons. And as one of his sons was expressing, when he asked him about love, he said, well, hey, I wanted to make sure that was the case. Because we all want to take time to love. Love conquers everything. Love covers a multitude of fault. Love covers up our sins. Love, and no greater love than this, that Jesus will lay down his life for his friend. So there's a time you have to make time to live, make time to love, but also have to make time for the Lord. You got to make time for the Lord. I love this setting today because we were able to get the whole balance of humanity. None of us are super spiritual, and none of us are worth casting away. We're all somewhere in the middle. We've seen his love for music, his love for photography, his love for his wife and his sons, and all of those that knew him knew he was straight up, no chaser. He loved to travel, Las Vegas, to the islands, but also what I do know, he loved the Lord. You also have to make time for your personal Savior, Jesus Christ. And I'm going to tell you why, because when you think about the reality of it all of our days are numbered. Unfortunately, as many of us are gathered and assembled here today, there will be a procession for each one of us. The one thing that I have always reflected on at a homegoing service is this. I never get used to them. It's always this reminder of the cold, brutal truth that one day we all are going to be rolled into a place, whether we decide to be buried in the graveyard or whether we decide that we're going to be cremated. But that's really not where the focus should be. The focus should be to make the most out of your time and give the Lord some time. So I'm talking to each of you this afternoon because the question is, what are you going to do with the time you have left? Are you going to insert the Lord somewhere in your life? I'm not against partying. I'm a party person. I'm not against love. I'm not against living your life to the fullest. But what I am for is making sure that there's always time for Jesus. There's always time for the one that sits up high and looks down low. There's always time for the one that when it's all over down here, and even if we have a one bedroom, if we have a one bedroom flat somewhere, the Bible says that in his house are many mansions. Amen. And if it were not so, Jesus said, I would have told you. He said, I'm going to prepare a place for you, Brother George Kelly. And where I am, there you may be also. So I know, like the woman was singing, and she sung it so beautifully and so powerfully, he's safe in the Lord's arms. But you can't be safe unless you know who he really is. Can I just ask you this morning, do you really know him for yourself? Can I ask you a question this morning? Do you know that when it's your time, that you're going to be safe in his arms? Can I make sure that you leave here this morning understanding you're going to make the most out of your time? We don't know how much longer we have, but what we do know is the one that holds the future in his hand. I tell you, like the Bible say, one day we're going to all be changed. In a moment, and a twinkling of an eye, the dead in Christ will rise first, and they that remain gonna be caught up to meet him in the air. I need you to look at somebody and wink your eye at them and say, it'll be that fast. One of these days, the trumpet of God will sound, and we gonna be with the Lord forever. So can you go ahead and put your hands together and thank God for the life of Brother Kelly? Because we all know that weeping may endure for a night, but joy will come in the morning. Sometimes it's a mighty long night, but if you hang on in there, one of these days you will be with Jesus. Brother George has lived his life, and we admire him because he made the most of his time. He lived his life, he enjoyed it, he danced, he sang, but he also loved. He loved his nephew, nieces. He loved his wife remarkably. He loved his sons, but he also loved the Lord. God bless you. May heaven continue to smile upon you. Sister Wanda, to the son, Brother Eric, and Brother George, God bless you. You have time. Make the most out of your time. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Dan. Sorry. Bless you. Thank you. Oh, no, no.